Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So on this auspicious first, is this the first day of Kartik? Yeah? So we're going to begin by speaking, continuing our discussion on the Srimad Bhagavatam. We're on the fifth canto, chapter number, what is it, chapter 18? 16?
Yeah, today is 18.
Yeah, the prayers offered to the Lord by the residents of Jambudvip. So Sukadeva Goswami is going to describe how these different varshas in Jambudvip, how the heads of each of the varsha, the kings of each of the varsha, how they offer their prayers to the different forms of the Lord.
Shukadeva Goswami 将为我们讲述在Jambudvip上面的这些varsha, 每个varsha这些国王, 他们是如何向主供奉他们的祷文的。
So Sukadeva Goswami begins by telling about a place called Badrashva Varsha.
Sukadeva Goswami 最开始讲的这个 Varsha 叫做 Badrashva Varsha.
And Badrashva Varsha is ruled by the son of Dharmaraj or the son of Yamaraj, who's called Badrashrava. And he's along with all, he has his different servants there and the different residents of that place. They all worship the expansion of Vasudev, known as Hayashirsha. Hayashirsha is very dear to the devotees.
Hayashirsha 对奉献者非常亲切.
And Badrashrava and his associates, they offer the they pray to the Lord in this way. Go ahead. They offer their obeisances unto the personality of Godhead, who cleanses the heart of the conditioned souls in the material world.
他们向主致以前进的顶拜，然后清洁他们的内心，向主献上祷文，小心翼翼地发生献上如下的祷文。So
people in the material world are very foolish, that they always thinking that they are going to enjoy material life.
人们在物质世界的人们总是非常的愚蠢，他们总是认为自己能够享受生活，享受生命。
Actually, in material world, we're being punished all the time. We're punished when we take birth, we're punished when we get old, we're punished with disease, and we're punished with death.
但是我们不知道的是，我们事实上是被受惩罚，我们被惩罚的生老病和死。
So, these kind of people, these materialistic people, they never want to surrender to Krishna.
这些物质主义者，他们从来不想臣服于 Krishna。
If they want to purify themselves, they have to worship Krishna by doing some austerity.
但是如果他们净化自己，他们如果想崇拜 Krishna 的话，他们必须净化自己，通过做一些苦行和忏悔。
But they're very attached to sense gratification. They just want to live in this world to enjoy their senses.
但是他们非常沉迷于感官享乐。
So Lord Rishabhdev told his 100 sons about the importance of doing austerity.
所以主 Rishabhdev 给他100个儿子的训谕是，在人体生命中应该做一些苦行。
If we will be willing to accept some austerity, we can purify our existence.
如果我们能够愿意接受一些苦行的话，我们能够净化我们自身的存在。
And when we purify ourselves, then we can experience real happiness.
如果我们能够净化我们的存在的话，那个时候我们才能够真正体会到真正的快乐。
People are thinking happiness is filling their belly or satisfying their genitals.
人们所认为的快乐是满足他的胃，满足他的生殖器。
They're thinking happiness can be obtained by sense gratification.
他们所谓的快乐是一种感官上的满足而已。
But that happiness is so temporary, it's such an illusion.
但是那样的快乐是非常的短暂，而且充满了愚昧的。
So that kind of happiness is only for foolish people who are covered by ignorance.
那样的快乐只为那些被愚昧覆盖的愚蠢的人所准备的。
But if we do some austerity and purify ourselves, then we can experience spiritual happiness.
如果我们能够做一些苦行，净化自己的话，我们那个时候能体会到一些灵性的快乐。
So in this way, this great devotee is praying to the Lord like this. He's praying that how amazing it is that people can be so stupid.
这些伟大的奉献者就是这样向主祈祷的。他说：“哎，这些愚蠢的物质主义者竟然是如此的愚蠢。”
Even though he knows death is sure is certainly going to come, he's going to die, but still he's so stupid. He's trying to enjoy.
虽然他们知道这个即将临死到头，而且充满了巨大的危险，他们仍是想要去享受。
When the father dies, then the son wants to enjoy the father's property.
当父亲死后，儿子就想享受父亲的财产。
And even if the man has a son, and if the son dies,He'll want to enjoy the son's property as well.
如果一个父亲他有一个儿子，如果那个儿子死去了，这个父亲也想享受这个儿子所拥有的财产。
Sometimes when the rich man has a son and the son dies, then the rich man he wants to enjoy his son's wife.
比如说有一些富有的人，当他的儿子死去的时候，这个富有的父亲甚至想享受他儿子的妻子。
You know, he's a father, he's an old man, he's a father, and still thinking about having sex, he wants to enjoy his son's wife.
我们知道他是一个老人，他是一个父亲， 但是他仍然非常享受他儿子的妻子。
So people are always trying to get money, try to get money, all the as much money as they can, just simply for sense gratification, for material pleasures.
人们总是想要得到钱，而这些钱就是想为了各种感官享乐。
They're thinking that money that will make me happy. With money, I will enjoy. Money is the honey.
他们认为这些钱能够给我带来快乐。这个钱能让我快乐。这个钱就是蜂蜜。
So material happiness is all centered around eating and sleeping, mating, defending.
物质的这种感官享乐其实就是意味着吃睡防卫和交配。
People who are materialistic, that's all they think about. They don't think about anything else.
物质主义者他总是围绕着这四项活动去思考，他不去想别的。
They don't think they're going to die, they're going to have to leave the body one day. They never think about that.
他不去想他自己会死，他有一天会死，他从来不会去思考这些事情。
So this is the power of the Lord's illusory energy, that it covers up the minds of people.
这就是主这个愚昧外在能量的这种力量，它能够覆盖这些人。
And so we can see how people are so unfortunate.That they just never even stop to think for a minute that I'm going to die.
我们看到这些人是如此的不幸，他们甚至连一分钟都没有去思考我将会死去这样的问题。
And they will do all kinds of sinful things without even hesitating.
他们做这些罪恶的活动的时候，从来都不会去犹豫。
And so somebody may ask, well, why does Krishna allow them to do these sinful things? Why doesn't he stop them?
有些人可能会问，为什么 Krishna 没有去阻止他们做这些事情？为什么 Krishna 允许他们去做这些事情呢？
Well, Krishna doesn't want them to do these sinful things, and he tries to get them to stop. He begs them through conscience.Through their conscience, he tries to tell them, don't do this, this is wrong.
当然，至尊主并不希望生物做任何的罪恶活动。他通过人们的良知告诉人们，这些事情是错的，不要做这些罪恶的活动。
The sinful people, they can actually feel somebody in the heart telling them, this is wrong, you shouldn't do this.
有一些罪恶的人，他有时候内心会有一些感受。他的那良知会告诉他，这个事情是错的，我不应该这么做的。
But they insist, no, I want to do it, I'm going to do it, you're not going to stop me. So then Krishna has to just let them do it.
但是这个人他坚持想要做，我想要做，没人可以阻挡我，所以至尊主就允许他这么做了。
So it's not that Krishna wants them to do these sinful things, but that they're so determined they're going to do it.
所以不是至尊主希望他们这么做，而是这个罪恶的人他非常有决心想要这么去做。
So he lets them do it, but they have to take the reactions for it. He's not responsible.
所以至尊主允许他这么做，但是这个人他必须承担他所做的事情的责任，至尊主却不为他承担这个责任。
On other planets, you'll never get the son dying before the father.
在其他的星球上，儿子总是比父亲活得长。
Even on the heavenly planets, you won't get.The son dying before the father.
即使在天堂星球上，你不会发现儿子会早死于父亲。
But it happens on this planet, this earth planet, it happens here.
但是在这个地球星球上，儿子经常比父亲早去世。
So we're all here, we're just waiting for our death. We know death is going to come and we're all just waiting. And when death comes, then all of our, we cannot plan anymore. No more material enjoyment. It's all finished. So the prayers go on, they pray to the Lord that we know that people who are advanced in spiritual knowledge, they know the nature of this material world, they know it's temporary.
我们知道有一些很有学识的人, 他们知道这个物质世界是短暂的, 将会被毁灭掉。
But what happens is sometimes they become bewildered by the Lord's illusory energy.
但是有些时候, 他们人受到主虚幻能量上的迷惑。
So this is the wonderful pastime of the Lord. The Lord's energy of illusion is very wonderful. So we offer our obeisances unto the Supreme Lord, knowing how powerful is His illusory energy. So this energy of Krishna is so powerful that it not only acts on the ordinary people, the conditioned souls, it can even act on advanced, learned scholars. Just like someone will think, I am this material body, and this is mine, this belongs to me, so this is illusion. But this illusion can also fall on the liberated soul. Liberated soul means somebody who has got knowledge about this world. So because he understands the nature of this world, he's not attached, he's not in the bodily concept of life. But because he's been with the modes of nature, he's been in association with the modes of nature for a long time, so sometimes he also falls in illusion. So the only way we can protect ourselves from not falling into that illusion is to surrender to Krishna. Right. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, this material energy is very difficult to overcome. But one who surrenders to me, he can easily cross beyond it. So we should be careful not to think that we are liberated and that we will never get affected by Maya. We have to be very careful. We have to be very strict in following the regulative principles and following the different rules and regulations.
我们应该非常严格的遵循规范原则，遵循各种各样的原则。
Earlier in this canto, fifth canto, we heard about Bharat Maharaj and how he was a little careless and he got attached to a deer.
在先前的篇章中，我们讲述了 Bharat Maharaj， 他是一个伟大的奉献者，但是他的注意力却转向了一头小鹿。
And when he became, because he became attached to a deer, next life he became a deer. And then he had to take another birth again as a brahmana. He became Jatpara.
由于他依附这条小鹿，所以下一生他成为了一只鹿。然后在另外再一次投生的时候，他成为了一个婆罗门，叫 Jatpara.
So he had to take two extra births because he was a little careless.
由于他的这种不小心，所以他多了两次投生。
And after he got liberated, he went home back to Gaudiya.
在这之后，他才得到解脱，回归受生。
So Krishna can excuse a devotee if you're a little careless. Krishna can forgive you, but don't take advantage of Krishna's mercy.
如果你不小心的话。主是可以原谅你，但是如果你利用主的这种原谅，主就会惩罚你。
Krishna, if we make the same mistake again and again, Krishna will have to punish us.
如果我们一再又一再、一再而三的去犯同样的这个错误的话，主肯定会惩罚我们。
So just having the knowledge of the theory, just knowing the knowledge from the books, that's not enough to protect us.
只是学习理论知识，书本上的知识不足以保护我们自己。
We have to really take shelter of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna in devotional service.
我们应该实实在在的非常强烈的依附于主的莲花足。
Yeah, one may have a lot of knowledge, one may have good knowledge and strong faith, but he may not have devotion.
有些人或许有很好的知识和信心，但是呢，他没有奉爱。
He never really thinks about Krishna and about trying to please Krishna.
他从来没有想过如何去取悦 Krishna.
He just wants to become a scholar and to know so many things.
他只想变成一个大学者，去知道很多的事情。
So it's so important.To develop a relationship, loving relationship with Lord Krishna.
因此，发展于 Krishna 的这种爱，如何去爱 Krishna 显得非常的重要。
Loving Krishna means also doing service for Krishna.
爱 Krishna 意味着为 Krishna 做服务。
We have to chant the holy name. We have to worship Krishna. We have to teach about Krishna.
我们应该唱诵圣名，我们应该崇拜 Krishna， 我们应该教授别人关于 Krishna。
So the prayers continue. They're praying to the Lord that we know you are detached from the work of maintaining the material world.
我们知这个祈祷继续，这个祈祷继续说，我们知道您完全不依附于这个物质创造的世界。
Yeah, you do the creation, you maintain it, and you destroy it. You do all of this. We know you're not affected by this, but you do it all.
您维创造、维系和毁灭这个物质世界，但是呢，您并不受这些活动的影响。
Because we know you have inconceivable energies, so you can do all of these things easily.
因为您有不可思议的能量，您可以很容易地做所有的这些事情。
So we know that everything is happening because of your inconceivable energy.
我们知道一切的事情发生就是由于您那不可思议的能量。
Very important to understand and to appreciate that the Lord has His inconceivable potency.
非常重要的，而且我们要欣赏主不可思议的能量。
And we give the example, inconceivable potency, just like the light of the sun, the energy coming from the sun every day. It's inconceivable. So much power, so much heat and light.
在描述主不可思议的能量的时候，我们可以举一个例子，就像太阳的光芒，太阳每天都发出这么多的热量和光芒，这就是主不可思议的一个能量。
The sun has been burning for so many years. We cannot put a date on when the sun began, and the sun continues to burn.
这个太阳从不可追忆的年代起，我们就不知道从什么时候开始起，它就一直不停的在燃烧，而且在我们之后，它还将继续这么燃烧着。
This is the inconceivable potency of the Lord.
这是主不可思议的能量所致。
But we try to understand the Lord with our limited material senses.
但是我们其实是通过我们有限的感官在了解至尊主。
We're like the frog in the well.
我们就像井底之蛙一样。
Right? The frog in the well is thinking, how big is the ocean? Is it 3 times as big as my well?
这个井底之蛙就会认为，这个海洋有多么大？只有我的这个井的三倍这么大吗？
Is it 4 times as big as my well?
有可能是我井的四倍这么大。
Can never understand the ocean in relation to the well.
他很难理解他的这个海洋跟他的井有多大的这种关联。
In the same way, materialistic scientists, they're trying to understand the unlimited, inconceivable potency of the Supreme.
同样的，这些物质主义科学家，他们总想用他们有限的这种力量去了解主。不可思议的能量。
And they try to measure everything. They want to know, is it, how powerful is it? But it's far beyond any power, any instrument to measure. They cannot measure. It's unlimited.
他无法理解主的这种不可思议的能量，超出，因为这些主的这个能量和力量完全超出他的想象范围之内。
Okay, so the prayers continue. And they describe, at the end of the millennium, there's a demon appears who is ignorance personified.
这个祈祷继续着，在年代的末尾，愚昧的化身变成为一个恶魔的形象。
And this demon stole all the Vedas, and he took them down to the planet Rasatala, one of the lower planets where the demons live.
而这个恶魔偷走了所有的伟达经，并把他们拿到了 Rasatala 星球。
But the Supreme Lord, in his form as Haigriva, he went and he brought back the Vedas and he gave them back to Lord Brahma.
然而，至尊主以哈亚圭瓦的形象拯救了伟达经，他把这个伟达经，然后又给了主 Brahma。
So we offer our obeisances unto the Lord, whose determination is very strong.
我向那位其决心永远不会失败的至尊主致以前进的顶拜。
So Vedic knowledge is sometimes when it's within the material world. Vedic knowledge sometimes it's there, sometimes it's not.
伟达的知识在这个物质世界有时候显现，有时候不显现。
But actually it's eternal, it's eternal knowledge, but just sometimes it's manifest, sometimes it's not.
但事实上伟达知识是不朽的，它只是有时候显现，有时候不显现。
We could say, just like Krishna, sometimes he's manifest, sometimes he's not. But he's always there.
就像主 Krishna 一样，他有时候显现，有时候不显现。但主 Krishna 永远都在那里。
Krishna is always there in Vrindavan, he's always there, but sometimes we see him, sometimes you don't see him.
Krishna 永远在 Vrindavan, 有时候我们能够看见他，有时候我们不能够看见他。
So when people become very, very much in the mode of ignorance and they forget about the importance of human life, then that, at that time, then the Vedic knowledge will disappear.
当人们太过于沉溺于愚昧之时，太过于沉迷于这种物质生活时，伟大知识就会消失。
But at that time, the Lord will come, either as Hayagriva or as Matsya, and He will protect the Vedic knowledge.
然而在那个时候，主哈耶圭瓦或 Matsya 总是保护着伟大知识。
And they will give that knowledge first to Brahma, and Brahma will distribute it.
他首先会把主首先会把这个伟大知识传给 Brahma， 然后主 Brahma 再派发这门知识。
Brahma is like the representative of the Lord in the universe.
主 Brahma 是在这个物质宇宙的，是主本人的代表。
So when Brahma wanted the Vedic knowledge, then the Lord is happy to give it to him.
当主 Brahma 希望得到伟大知识的时候，至尊主也非常喜欢，非常高兴地把这个伟大知识给予他。
So then Sukadeva Goswami goes on to describe about another place called Harivarsha. And in Harivarsha, Lord Nrsingadev resides.
Sukadeva Goswami 继续描述到下一个 Varsha 叫 Harivarsha. 在 Harivarsha 这片土地上，主比辛哈德瓦住在那里。
So Prahlad Maharaj, the topmost devotee, he caused Lord Nrsingadev to appear.
Prahlad Maharaj 这位顶尖的奉献者，他让主女星和对方显现了。
And Prahlad Maharaj has very wonderful qualities. He's a very great personality. His character and activities are all very perfect.
Prahlad Maharaj 有非常多优秀的品质，他的活动和行为都非常的完美。
So Prahlad Maharaj performs activities to deliver the fallen members because his family are all demons. So Prahlad Maharaj delivers them by his activities.
Prahlad Maharaj 的家庭都是恶魔的堕落成员，但是他的品格和活动拯救了他的恶魔家庭和所有堕落的成员。
So Prahlad Maharaj is there in Harivamsa, and along with all of his servants.And all the people of Harivarsha, they all worship Lord Nrsingadev.
So, Prahlad Maharaj and Harivamsa, this Hari 家族的这些成员，他们都崇拜主Harivarsha， 他们都崇拜主Nrsingadev。
So, Lord Nrsingadev, Sukadeva Goswami.Sukadeva Goswami is speaking about Lord Nrsingadev because of Prahlad Maharaj.
Sukadeva Goswami, 要讲 Nrsingadev 也是因为 Prahlad Maharaj.
Prahlad Maharaj's life was in danger, and Lord Nrsingadev appeared and saved him from his father, who was going to kill him.
Prahlad Maharaj 当时处于危险之中，主 Nrsingadev 显现救了他，杀了。
So, Krishna is the original person, but he can assume many different forms for his devotees, to please his devotees.
Krishna 是原初的这个形象，但是他也扩展出其他的形象，为了取悦他的奉献者。
So in the Dasavatar Stotra, Jayadeva Goswami always says the name Keshava.Then Keshava is the name of the personality of Godhead.
在 Jayadeva Goswami 写的这个主的十个化身的这一个歌曲之中，经常描述到 Keshava. Keshava 是主 Krishna 的一个名字。
Keshava Drita Narahari Rupa. Keshava Drita Matsya Sharera. Keshava Drita Rama Sharera. Keshava Drita Vamana Rupa. All of these are all different names of the Lord, but Jayadeva Goswami always uses the name Keshava, because Keshava means the original personality of Godhead.
These songs 里面经常有 Keshava, Keshava Drita, Keshava Drita. 虽然这些里面包含的主很多其他的名字，但是加堆塔哥斯瓦米一直用 Keshava， 因为 Keshava 的意思是主 Krishna 原初的一个名字。
So this is a beautiful prayer given by Prahlad Maharaj and the residents of Harivamsa, how they pray to Lord Nrisingadev.
下面是这个非常优美的一个祷文，由 Prahlad Maharaj 向这个 Nrisingadeva 供奉的一个祷文。
Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya Namaste Jaste Jase Avira Virbhava Brajanaka Brajadamstra Karmasaya Ramdaya Randaya Tamo Grasa Grasa Om Swaha Abhayam Abhayam Atmani Bhuvishtam Om Shrom。Right, so that's the verse, a very beautiful verse offered to Lord Nrisingadev. The people of Harivamsa, led by Prahlad Maharaj, offer their prayer to Lord Nrisingadev, who possesses nails and teeth like thunderbolts.
This is a Prahlad Maharaj 向女星哈供奉的祷文。我向一切力量的源泉主女星哈 Deva 致以前进的顶拜。我那拥有闪电般指甲和牙齿的主啊。
He says, kindly vanquish our demonic-like desires for fruit of activity in this material world.
请仁慈地摧毁我们欲求在物质世界中进行功利性果报活动的恶魔般的愿望。
Please appear in our hearts, drive away our ignorance, so that by your mercy we may become fearless in the struggle for existence in the material world.
请您显现在我们的心中，驱除我们的愚昧，以便借着您的仁慈，我们在这个物质世界中为生存而奋斗时无所畏惧。
So, Srimad Bhagavatam is like that. It's the residents of Harivamsa, they pray to Lord Nrisingadev to purify their consciousness.
在圣典博迦瓦坛，就是这样的。这个 Harivamsa, 他们献出了这个祷文，希望净化他们内在的知觉。
Because in material life, people are very fruitive. We have a lot of fruitive desires to enjoy the material world. So this is demonic. This is a demonic tendency to want to enjoy the material world. Nothing actually belongs to us. It all belongs to the Supreme Lord. Isyavashyamidam sarvam yatkincha jagadyam jagat tena chaktena bunjata makridaha kasha siddhanam. Everything animate and inanimate that is within the universe is controlled and owned by the Lord.
由言自主的一切的都来自于主，都由主控制。
We should take only what is our quota. We should not take more than what we need, knowing well to whom everything belongs.
我们应该只拿走我们所需要的一部分，永远不要拿走不属于我们的这一部分。
Prabhupada gives the example. He said, just like a bag of rice may be lying there, the little bird will come and take a few grains and he will go away, he's happy. But the man will come, he'll want to take the whole bag.
就像地上有一袋米，有一些鸟呢，它可能会只是去吃一点点米，吃完之后它就走了。但是如果一个人过去，他就把一袋子米全拿了。
So this is our nature in the material life, where we have this desire. We want to conquer, we want to enjoy, we want everything.
This is our desire, our
And that's why we're struggling very hard with the material nature.
而就是因为这些，我们就在这个物质世界里非常挣扎的生存。
Manashastani Indriyani Prakriti Stani Karshati, struggling very hard with the six senses, including the mind.
与心意在内在内的六种感官不同，就是一直不停的挣扎着。
So Prahlad Maharaj prays to Lord Nrisimhadeva, if you will come in our heart, you can take away this ignorance.
所以 Prahlad Maharaj 向主 Nrisimhadeva 祈祷，请你显现在我的内心，拿走这些愚昧和愿望。
And then we will be fearless in this material world.
如此这样，我们就可以在这个物质世界无所畏惧。
A devotee asked Prabhupada.He said, what do you feel when you chant Hare Krishna?
有奉献者就问圣帕帕德，当你在念诵 Hare Krishna 的时候，你的感受是什么？
Prabhupada said, I feel no fear.
圣帕帕德说，我感到无所畏惧。
That is real chanting. No fear. We don't fear anything because we understand fully we're not the body.We're spirit soul, there's no reason for anxiety, there's nothing to fear.
这是真正的好的纯粹的念诵，当我们在念诵的时候，我们这种纯粹的念诵就意味着我们不是这个躯体，我们在这个物质世界没有什么好惧怕。
So in material life we see people, even great yogis, jnanis,It's very difficult for them to conquer over their mind and senses.
这些非奉献者们，这些 Gyani Yogi 们，他们非常难以克服感官享乐的。
But for a devotee, it's very easy because devotees are so fully engaged in Krishna's service.
但是对于奉献者来说是很容易的，因为奉献者总是全神贯注于奉献服务。
Devotees have taken shelter of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna.
主 Krishna 奉献者总是托庇于主 Krishna 的莲花足。
We see sometimes in the river Ganga, there's a strong current, and sometimes you see even a big animal, sometimes a big elephant even gets in the Ganga, it can't get out, it gets carried away.
在这个恒河，我们有时候会发现有一些巨大的漩涡。当这个，即便是一头大象，它也很难挣脱出来。
The current of the Ganga is so strong. Even you may be a good swimmer, the current will just carry right down out into the sea.
这个流动是非常大的。即便你是一个非常好的这个游泳手，你也很难。
But the little fish in the water, they can go on right through, they can swim against the current, they don't have any problem.
但是对于一个小鱼来说，它是很容易的，它是很容易的游过这些逆流或者说漩涡的。
Because the little fish has taken shelter of the Ganga, so she can go.
但是这些是因为这些小鱼，它们非常，它们托庇于刚刚，所以它们能够很容易的跨越。
Sometimes you see also the lion, she has her cubs, and the cubs, you know, lion is very fearsome, very fearful, but the little cubs are not afraid of their mother, because they've taken shelter of their mother.
我们看到这个狮子是非常凶残的，但是它的这些小崽子们，他托庇于他的狮子，就一点对他的狮子就不害怕。
So the same way for the devotee, take shelter of Krishna, so they're not troubled by the material energy.
所以对于奉献者来说，如果我们托庇于 Krishna, 我们也不没有必要对这个物质能量害怕。
There's no the desire to enjoy the material world.Is not there in the devotee because he's enjoying something better in the service of Krishna.
奉献者没有这种物质感官享乐的欲望，因为他们在服务的时候能够享受到更高级的这种。
But people who have got this desire for material sense gratification, they're struggling, they're fighting, they have to take birth again and again in the material world.
但是存有这种物质欲望的这些物质主义者，他们会为此而不断的争斗，而且一世复一世的挣扎。
They can never get rid of their material desires, one after another.
他们不可能从他们一个又一个的物质欲望之中挣脱出来。
They know these desires are all centered on lust, and the lust is burns like fire, never satisfied.
这些欲望根深蒂固，就像这些色欲，就像燃烧的火一样。
So they can never understand the nature of devotional service.
他们很难理解奉献者的本质。
Their ignorance does not allow them to appreciate what is devotional service.
他们的愚昧允许他们，允许 allow them to appreciate
devotional service.
他们的愚昧允许他们欣赏奉献服务。
It does not allow them to appreciate.
他们的愚昧不允许他们欣赏奉献服务。
So that's why we pray to Lord Nrisimhadev, because he killed Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu represents material desire.
这就是我们为什么要向主尼辛哈德瓦祈祷的原因。尼辛哈德瓦杀死了黑人亚卡西普，黑人亚卡西普代表了物质欲望。
Hiranya means gold, and Kashipu means soft bed.
Hiranya 的意思是黄金， Kashipu 的意思是软床。
So materialistic people, they all want these things. They want the money and they want the bed.
物质主义者要的就是这些事情，他要。
They just think about the body, make the body happy, comfortable.
他们总是想着他们的身体，让他们的身体变得舒适。
Have gold and decorate the body with gold ornaments, make oneself beautiful.
然后让他们的身体装饰着黄金，让他们身体因装饰着黄金而变得美丽。
Then sleep on the soft bed and sleep all you like, as long time, many hours, all day.
然后睡在一个柔软的床上，他们想能够想睡多久就睡多久，最好能够睡一天。
So Hiranyakashipu, he represented all this material life, all the things materialistic people want.
Hiranyakashipu代表了就是这种物质主义者的生活，而他也是这些物质主义者所向往的。
And of course, he hated devotees. He hated to hear about Krishna, and he was going to kill Prahlad Maharaj because he was a devotee.
Hiranyakashipu 非常憎恨奉献者，他也憎恨主 Krishna, 他想杀掉帕拉德马哈拉吉。
So anybody who wants to get free of material desires, right? Anybody out there wants to get free of material desires? Then what you have to do, offer prayers to Lord Nrisimhadev, just like Prahlad Maharaj did.
所有这些想从物质愿望中得到解脱的人，就应该像帕拉德马哈拉吉一样，向主尼辛哈德瓦祈祷。
So Prahlad Maharaj continues to pray. He said, let there be nice, good fortune throughout the universe.
Prahlad Maharaj 继续祈祷道，愿好运遍及宇宙的上下。
And let all the envious people be pacified.
愿所有心怀嫉妒的人都平和起来。
And let all the living entities become calm by doing bhakti yoga.
愿所有的生物通过修习奉爱瑜伽而变得平和。
Because if they do bhakti yoga, they will think about other people, about the benefit of other people.
因为如果他们做练习奉爱瑜伽的话，他们就会想着其他人的福祉。
So Prahlad Maharaj prays, let us all do service for Lord Krishna.
Prahlad Maharaj 说，愿我们能够所有的人都能够向主 Krishna 做奉献。
Let us always be thinking of him.
让我们总是专注于想着主 Krishna。
So Prahlad Maharaj is the ideal devotee. He's teaching us the mood of a devotee.
主Prahlad Maharaj 是一位理想的奉献者，他告诉人们，他教授奉献者。
Right. Prahlad is not asking for himself, but he's asking for all the people.
Prahlad Maharaj 没有想着他自己，他想的是所有的其他人。
He's asking for the gentle people, the envious people, the bad people.
他为温和的人、嫉妒的人以及那些坏人为他们所祈祷。
Prahlad Maharaj was always even thinking about his own father who was so bad, he was such a demon.
Prahlad Maharaj 甚至想着他的父亲的福祉，因为而他的父亲是一位恶棍，是一个恶魔。
And he, when after Lord Narsingadev killed him, Prahlad Maharaj prayed that his father would not have to go to hell.
当 Narsingadev 杀了他的父亲，杀了黑人阿卡西布的时候， Prahlad Maharaj 向主祈祷，希望他不要去地狱。
So this is the proper mood of a Vaishnava, that he's always thinking about others, not thinking about himself.
这是一个外士那瓦奉献者的恰当的心态，他总是想着其他人，而不是想着自己。
We see people, materialistic people, spend all their time they're just envious of other people.
我们看这些充满了嫉妒的人，这些物质主义者，他们总是嫉妒着他人。
But the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, teachings of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, they're meant for people who are free of envy, who've given up envy. Right, Krishna says to Arjuna, because you're not envious of me, I'm speaking this knowledge.
主 Krishna 对 Arjuna 说，因为你从不嫉妒我，所以我向你讲授这门知识。
And Srimad Bhagavatam also begins that this is meant for those who are not envious.
圣典摩迦瓦坛也是以这种开始了，愿所有心怀就是为那些免于嫉妒的人所写的。
Dharma prajita kaitavo traparamo nirmat saranam shatam. Right? This Bhagavad Purana propounds the highest truth, which has nothing to do with cheating religion. And it's understood by those who are not envious, who are free of envy.
This is the highest truth, Shengdian Bhojawatan. It is not a cheating religion. The highest truth, and then
highest truth, and people who are, and for people who are free of envy.
为那些免于嫉妒的人所写。
And it's not cheating religion like others.
它不像其他的欺骗的宗教一样。
So this world, material world, is full of so many envious people.
这个物质世界充满了嫉妒的人。
But if we get free of envy, then we can become we can think about other people, helping other people.
这个世界充满了嫉妒，如果我们能够免于嫉妒，我们才能够真正的帮助他人。
So, to do this, we have to become Krishna conscious. We have to clean the heart.
而要做到这一点，我们必须要有 Krishna 知觉，要清洁我们的内心。
So we should pray to Lord Narsingadev to sit in our hearts. Prabhupada says, Bahir Narsingho Hridaye Narsinga. Lord Narsingadev, let Lord Narsingadev sit in the core of my heart and kill all my bad qualities. Let Lord Narsingadev sit in the core of my heart. Then my mind will become clean. Then I can worship the Lord and bring peace to the world. So whenever we offer a prayer to the Lord, we should always request some benediction from Him. Even like Lord Chaitanya prays in the Shikshastikam. He says, O son of Nanda, I am your eternal servant. Please pick me up from the ocean of death. Fix me as an atom at your lotus feet. Lord Chaitanya also prays, just let me have devotional service birth after birth.
主柴潘尼亚又说, 让我一世又一世地为您做奉献。
So when Prahlad Maharaj prays Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya, he prays for a benediction. But because he's a devotee, he doesn't want anything for his own self. He doesn't want sense gratification. He wants there to be auspiciousness in the universe. And he wanted the Lord to be, Lord Narsingadev, to be merciful even to his father, who was very envious. So Haranyakashi, it said there are two kinds of envious entities. One is the snake, and the other is the man like Haranyakashipu. Haranyakashipu was even envious of his son, even Prahlad. He was envious of Prahlad. But Haranyakashipu is envious of Prahlad, he's envious of the devotees. But Prahlad just wished that his father could get the mercy of the Lord. He wanted that his father shouldn't be a demon, that he could become a devotee. So snakes can be controlled by mantras, but Haranyakashipu couldn't be controlled by mantra. So Prahlad Maharaj prays that all the envious people can get a change of heart and become good people. So this is the work of the Krishna Consciousness Movement, to make all the envious people into good people.
这就是 Krishna 知觉运动的工作，让那些嫉妒的人变成好人。
In Krishna consciousness, no one is envious of anyone else.
在 Krishna 知觉之中，没有一个人嫉妒他人。
Everyone thinks about others.
每一个人都想着其他人的福祉。
So Prahlad Maharaj wants that everybody will become gentle and will get shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna.
Prahlad Maharaj 希望每一个人都变得温和，都能够托庇于主的莲花足。
Materialists only think of sense gratification, but Prahlad Maharaj prays that Krishna or Lord Nrisingadev can change their minds.
物质主义者总是想着感官享乐，但帕拉达马哈拉的祈祷主的仁慈能够改变他们的心态。
If they can think of Krishna, then that will be good.
如果他们能够想着 Krishna, 一切就会变好。
So some people say, well, if everybody thought of Krishna, then everybody would go back to Godhead, then the world would be empty.
有些人就会这么说，如果每个人都想着 Krishna, 每个人就会因此而重返家园，回归守神，而没有人，而这个时候地球就会空荡了。
But we should remember that there's an infinite number of living entities.
但是我们应该知道，生物是无数的。
And if one set of living entities are all made Krishna conscious, another set,of living entities will come and fill up the universe.
有一批生物拥有了 Krishna 知觉得到拯救，另一批生物就又会充满整个宇宙。
Okay, so we'll stop there today.
好，我们今天先讲到这儿。
We'll ask if there's any questions.
目前还没有看到萨提玛的。
稍等一下。
Guru Dev, 我有一个问题。
OK。
圣帕帕德说，非奉献者的心中不可能有优秀的品质，但是我们也听一些奉献者说，有一些奉献者的品质甚至没有世俗之人的品质那么好。那么这样的话是不是不恰当的？还是说以情况而定？Srila Prabhupada said,Long devotees can't have good qualities in their hearts. So when someone said that some devotees are not even as good as secular people, is that inappropriate? Or should it depend on the situation?
Devotees are not even as good as secular people?
As material people.
So your question, is that what?
Is that this sentence are inappropriate?
The devotees are not as good as the secular people.
Yes. Sometimes devotees don't do good things. So some devotees criticize, say that like that, devotees are not.As material people.
Well, it may appear like that, but the fact is that because someone's a devotee, in course of time they will gradually rectify themselves and they will become very good.
This thing may be seen as this. Although at the time the contributor performed not so well, but as time goes on, the contributor will gradually rectify.
But somebody is not a devotee, then they're always struggling with the three modes of nature. So they'll never have
good... 但是没有，但是没有，没有那些不是奉献者的人，他们因为不是奉献者，所以他们总是在物质自然之中受到挣扎。
They're always struggling, sometimes in goodness, sometimes in passion, sometimes in ignorance.
他 们总是挣扎，有时候处于善良，有时候是激情的，有时候就是愚昧的。
But if one is actually devotee, and he's working in devotional service, then he's transcendental.
但是如果一个人是奉献者，他所有的这些行为，他就会变得超然。
And gradually he will develop the best qualities.
逐渐他会发展出最好的品质。
Just will take some time.
只是需要花一点时间而已。
Okay. Any question then?
Okay. Sati Mataji 问，这个是您的问题吗 ，Sati Mataji？
对，是的，是的。
Okay. 当我们在做服务的时候，总觉得自己做的服务不如别人的好，总是内心不满足，从而产生出嫉妒之心。请问 Guruji， 这种不满足是怎么产生的？是嫉妒的根源吗 ？I want to ask, when we do the devotional service, we feel our service is not as good as others, so in our heart is not satisfied. Sometimes also envies in our heart.I want to ask Guruji, this unsatisfaction, how this unsatisfaction come, is also a kind of envy?
No, not envy. This is just simply the desire to do better for Krishna.
这不是嫉妒，这只是想做更好的服务来取悦 Krishna, 做更好的服务而已。
Yeah, but the devotee naturally wants to give the best to Krishna. And he's always thinking that I haven't really done enough for Krishna. I should do better.
奉献者总是想把最好的给 Krishna. 他认为自己总是没有给予最好，所以他总是想把更好的给 Krishna.
So this is the proper mood of the devotee, that we want to give the best for Krishna. No matter what we do, we think, you know, I should try to do better.
无论我们做了什么，这其实是一个恰当的心态。我们总认为我们没有做得更好，我们应该做更好的给 Krishna.
So, it's actually good you're thinking like that you're not satisfied with your service and you see others doing well and you think, oh, I would like to do more. It's not envy, but it's a desire to want to do better, to give more to Krishna. That's transcendental.
如果你能这么想，这是非常好的，因为你总是想着做更好的服务给 Krishna. 这不是嫉妒，这是想做更好的，这是超然的这种心态。
Just like one gopi, serving Krishna, and they see another gopi, and they think, oh, that other gopi served Krishna so nicely, and so they will pray, maybe they will go to that gopi and ask them, please bless me that I can also serve Krishna as well as you have done.
就像木流姑娘们有时候也会出现这样，当一个木流姑娘发现另一个姑娘很取悦 Krishna 的时候，她会到这个木流姑娘那里去祈祷她，请你也祝福我，我能够像你一样能够这么取悦 Krishna。
So this is nice transcendental feelings that you have. You want to offer the best to Krishna. You want to do more service for Krishna.
这是一个很好的而且超然的感受，对于奉爱服务，你想把最好的给 Krishna， 你想把最好的给 Krishna。
Okay, any other question? Maybe in Dohan Mang, Damodar, you're a high shit. Okay. Can we stop there tonight then?
暂停吗？没停。
我们今天结束可以吗？
嗯，可以，古代。是的，我们暂时没有收到更多的问题。
Okay. Okay, 所以我们感谢苏布里普布给我们翻译，感谢萨提主持，感谢奉献者聆听，祝福你们。嗯，
感谢。
达摩达尔快乐。哈哈哈。达尔
快乐。
好，达尔快乐。
Hare Krishna.
好，那我们今天的网课，哦，Govindarandini Madaji问了一个问题。
哦。
请问 Guruji， 灵魂有自己的心意智性吗？
灵魂有自己。
Does the soul have his own intelligent or mind?
Well, these things are all there within the soul.It's all part of the soul, the activities, the functions which are there in the subtle body are all there within the soul. It doesn't have a material mind, it has a spirit, the spiritual activities are all there within the, from the soul. Because we have a spiritual body, we have spiritual senses, so there's also the spiritual mind. It's all there, it's all part of the spiritual body. It's all one.
在灵性的这个躯体是有这些功能的，但是呢，它不是物质的。灵性的躯体有心意，有智性，但是它是纯净的这些功能。
Yeah,
We
know that there are eight elements of the material energy, the five gross elements and the three subtle elements. So they stay in the material world, but the soul goes back to Godhead and the soul has its spiritual body.The spiritual body will certainly also have to have a mind, will have to be spiritual mind, spiritual intelligence, it will all be there within the soul. And the spiritual bodies are all eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. So these qualities are all there within the spiritual body. It's not like he has a subtle spiritual mind. It's all.Done from the soul.
而它这个灵性的躯体不像我们这种精微的躯体的这种状态，它全部都在它这个灵性的躯体里面，灵性的灵魂里面。
Of course, it's difficult for us to understand exactly the spiritual body because we only have experience of this material body.
当然，对于我们了解这种灵性的躯体是很难的，因为我们只有这种物质的躯体。
We're still conditioned to this material world.
我们仍然在这个受条件的物质世界之内。
But the liberated souls, those in the spiritual world, they have their spiritual bodies, they have spiritual activities.They have everything.
但是灵性世界解脱了这些灵魂，在灵性世界，他们有灵魂，有一切。
So there's senses, there's mind also. They have to think and do things. They take part in activities and do service for Krishna.
他们用灵性的感官、灵性的心意、智力做一些服务给 Krishna。
But it's all spiritual.
但是所有的这一切都是灵性的。
It's not the material energy anymore.
Sorry?
It's not material, it's not like the material energy where we have to struggle with our mind and control our mind.
这不像我们的这种物质能量，我们总是在与我们的心意在做挣扎。
The spiritual world, they're all pure devotees, their bodies are eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. There's no question of controlling the mind.
在灵性世界，所有人都有灵性的心，灵性的躯体，所有人都是纯粹的奉献者，他们不必要去控制心意。
But there are feelings and there are emotions.And they're all in relation to devotional service in Krishna.
他们所有的感受和情感都是和对 Krishna 的奉爱服务是相关联的。
There's no bad feelings, there's no envy, there's no bitterness.
他们没有这种不好的感受，没有这种嫉妒。
Everyone is full of bliss and knowledge.
所有人充满着快乐和知识。Next question.
Yeah.
This question from Kirtananda David Dasi. 请问孤儒，研习经典比冥想圣名重要吗？哪个更好 ？I want to ask a guru. Reading the study the sutra.Is important than the meditation, the holy name, which is important?
Well, they're both important.
两个都非常重要。
If you're going to chant the holy name, you have to understand why we're chanting the holy name.
如果你想去唱诵圣名的话，你应该了解为什么你要唱诵圣名。
And you have to understand whose name we're chanting.And you have to understand what should be the proper mood in chanting.
你要了解我们唱诵的谁的名字，我们应该怀着什么样的心态唱诵这个名字。
And when we chant the holy name, there are offenses to be avoided in chanting the holy name.
当我们唱诵圣名的时候，同时还要避免一些实相冒犯的原则。
So the fourth offense.Is to blaspheme the Vedic literature or any literature in pursuance of the Vedic version.
第四项冒犯是冒犯亵渎伟达文献。
So if we're not reading the books regularly, then that is an offense.
如果我们没有有规律的阅读经典的话，这就是一种冒犯。
Prabhupada wrote the books for his devotees to read.
圣帕帕德写书是为了他的奉献者去阅读。
And you read the books, and then you get inspired to chant Hare Krishna better.
如果你阅读圣帕帕德的书，你会更好的唱诵圣名。
You understand why we chant Hare Krishna.
你会理解为什么我们要唱诵圣名。
So they go together. You have to read the books, and you have to chant.
所以这两者是一致的，你阅读书籍，然后同时也要念诵。
If you want to develop a taste for reading the books, you have to chant.
你想获得对阅读的品味，你也得念诵。
And if you read the books, you'll get more taste for chanting.
而你念诵，你会获得念诵中，你阅读的话，你会获得对念诵中的更多的品味。
So the two things go together. You can't separate them. You can't have one without the other.
所以这两者是一起的，你不能把一者分开，或者分开这两者，只要其中的一个。
Somebody may be reading the books but not chanting. then it means they're not really applying the knowledge in the books.
有一些人或许在读书，但是他并不念诵，而这样的人就意味着他并没有去实践书中的这些教导。
Yeah, the knowledge, all the books tell us the importance that we have to chant, that we should chant the holy name.
因为所有的书都告诉我们，我们应该唱诵，我们应该唱诵圣名。
So you just, if you read the books, you just become a gyani. You don't develop your real love for Krishna.
如果你只是读书的话，你就会成为一个 gyani， 你不会发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
So it's important. We want to be a devotee. The one who's a devotee will chant the holy name, and he will also read the books.
我们是想成为一个奉献者，而一个奉献者是唱诵主的圣名，然后也读 Krishna 的书。
So don't separate them. Don't just think I'm just going to read or I'm just going to chant. It won't work.
不要分开，不要只做其中的一个，不要把它们分开。
Every day you have to try to chant. You should also try to read a little, try to hear.
每一天你都应该去念诵，同时也应该试着去读书，去聆听。
And if you can hear regularly, it will help you to develop a good taste for chanting.
如果你能有很有规律的去聆听的话，你会在念诵之中获得品味。
Okay, so that was a good question.
这是一个很好的问题。
Very important.
Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Kelly Lanita, Madhaji. Dimbai Gurudev.有个所谓的奉献者，他已经学习 Krishna 之觉快20年了。从我认识他那天开始，他就展示出家庭主妇的品质，联谊的时候很小气，只想占便宜，不愿意付出，非常抠门，没有文化，甚至至今未改。这样的人算是奉献者吗？顶拜姑内，a kind of devotees.I know her, learn Krishna, start in Krishna consciousness 20 years, practice Krishna consciousness 20 years. But when I know her from that day, he showed his quality of household woman, Grihastha woman. When association with her, she showed very.Petty, very narrow, and she just wants the benefit from others and don't want to pay for. And I think she has no culture. So is this person like devote, as a devotee?
Well, yes.There's, because if she's chanting the holy name, she's coming to be with devotees, she's like a devotee. But she's a long way to go. She has a long way to go. She has a lot of faults. But with good association and encouragement, somebody has to put some effort into training her and guiding her and telling her what she needs to do.
是的，他是一个奉献者。如果他能够唱诵圣名，同时他也能够和奉献者联谊的话，他就是一个奉献者。但是他还有很长的路要走。如果能够在这条路上有人能够指导他、帮助他的话，他就能够变得更好。
We try to accommodate everyone in the Krishna consciousness movement.
We
would like to have everyone in Krishna consciousness.
我们希望所有的人都有 Krishna 知觉。
But Srila Prabhupada did say, that we didn't want lazy people or crazy people.
圣帕帕的,
he did say,
圣帕帕的说,
我们不希望疯狂的和懒惰的人。 So you have to consider, is this woman crazy or is she lazy?
所以我们得看一看这个人, 他是懒惰还是说疯狂?
I don't know. I wouldn't like to judge.
我不知道, 我也不希望去评判。
But she has to do some service.
但是她应该做一些奉献服务。
If she's not going to do any service, then we don't need her.
如果她不做任何的服务的话, 我们不需要她。
Everyone has to do some service.
每一个人都应该做一些奉献服务。Next question.
Yes.
From Nalita Prana. 顶拜Gurudev的莲花族, 你心和Deva保护奉献者,帮助奉献者去除物质愿望, 可有的时候向主祈祷,请主帮助自己去除某种物质欲望后, 这个物质欲望似乎并没有减少,有时好像更明显的,这是什么原因呢?有时候,这个时候我们应该怎么办? Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, Nrisimhadeva protect devotees and clear the material desire of the devotees, but sometimes we pray to the Lord, ask the Lord to help us to clear this material desire, and then our desire seems not minus, but increase and appear more. So why and how to do in this condition?
Well, we have to control the mind. Material desires are coming from the mind.
我们应该控制心意。 这个物质的愿望都来自于心意。
You want the Lord to take that desire out of your mind, you have to also be cooperative, you have to help Him to get it out of your mind.
你想让主来帮助你清除你内心的愿望,你得和主合作,一起把那个愿望给清除掉。
If your desire is just increasing, it means you're holding on to that desire. You don't want to let go.
如果你的愿望更多了,这只是表明你在一直抓着那个愿望,你并没有让这个愿望给离开。
So you have to let go. If you're trying to hold on, you pray to Him to take it away, but you're trying to hold on to it at the same time, it's not good.
你想让主抓着这个愿望,帮你清除这个愿望,但是你又一直抱着那个愿望,这并不太好。
So we have to let go. The Lord's willing to take it away, but if we're trying to hold on to it, it's very difficult.
主是非常乐意帮我们清除这个愿望的,但是如果我们坚持要把这个愿望给抱住的话,这是非常困难。
Okay, that's the problem.
Okay, next question.
Yes.
Next question from Chanchala Devindasi. Hare Krishna, Dimbai Gurudev, 书里讲的超然的知识,把我们展示和没展示的一切业报统统烧尽,如何理解呢? 感谢翻译,谢谢。 Hare Krishna, obeisance to Gurudev, in the scriptures said, the transcendental knowledges can burn our all manifest and unmanifest karma. So how to understand?
How does it happen?
Yes. How to understand that transcendental knowledge can burn all our karma?
Yes. When we cultivate transcendental knowledge, that knowledge will remove the karma.
当我们培养超然的知识的时候，超然的知识能够移去我们的业报。
Transcendental knowledge is compared to the fire, right? It burns up the all the sinful reactions.
超然的知识被比喻为是一团火，能够燃烧掉我们的罪恶。
So this is the power of the transcendental knowledge. It can remove the reactions to past sins.
这就是超然知识的力量，它能够去除我们所做的这些罪恶。
We have to cultivate this transcendental knowledge very carefully.
我们应该仔细地学习，小心地学习，仔细地学习这些超然的知识。
And the effect of that transcendental knowledge is it will remove the sinful reactions of our past.
而这个超然的知识就可以去除我们过去所做的罪恶。
Just like we say about devotional service can also remove the sins of our past.
就像我们说奉爱服务，奉爱服务同样可以去除我们过去的罪恶。
So transcendental knowledge also has that power.
超然的知识同样有这种力量可以去除。
So transcendental knowledge can remove the sinful desires, but they can come back again.
超然的知识可以去除我们的这种罪恶的欲望，然后这种罪恶的欲望有时候也会再回来。
Because the root.Which is below the ground, the root is not burned up. Only what's on the surface is removed by the fire.
因为这种根源没有被连根拔起，我们烧掉的只是这个欲望的表层。
So the root comes up and grows up, and again the material desires come and trouble us.
然后这个欲望又会长出。就成为这种物质愿望，物质欲望又骚扰我们。
But devotional service is more powerful.
但是奉爱服务会更有力量。
It will pull out the root.
它会把这种根连根拔起。
So fire burns up all the trees, all the foliage.Then if there's a fire in the forest, you see all the trees burned up, right?
所以这个火在森林里面燃烧的时候，我们看见所有的一切都燃烧，这个树啊，地上的叶子啊，都被燃烧起来。
So transcendental knowledge works like that, just like the fire burns up the sinful reactions.
超然的知识就是像这样，他把一切的这种罪恶都给燃烧。
The sinful reactions, some are manifest and some are not, but they're all burned up.
罪恶的这种反应，有时候有反应，有时候没有反应，但是超然的知识都可以把它给燃烧殆尽。
This is the power, transcendental knowledge.
这是超然知识的力量。
People get transcendental knowledge, they get freed, sinful reactions.
人们得到超然的知识，他可以从罪恶之中得到解救。
Okay.
Next question. From the Harivamsa Prabhu.
我们平时的心意智性被净化后，是不是就是灵魂的心意智性？灵魂是需要净化，还是只需要唤醒原本纯粹的灵魂的智性？
So our mind and intelligence are purified. Is that means the soul's mind and purified? After the mind and intelligence purified, then it becomes the soul's intelligence and the mind.
Higher than the senses is the mind, higher than the mind is intelligence, and he, the soul, is higher still.
比心意更高的是智性，比智性更高的是灵魂。
So that's in the material body.
这是物质躯体。
The soul is always pure.
灵魂总是纯净的。
But some, it's covered, it becomes covered.
但是它是被覆盖。
So we have to remove the covering from the soul.
我们应该把灵魂上面的覆盖给拿走。
Just like now that winter is coming, we will cover more the body with blanket at night to keep warm.
就像冬天来了，我们晚上的时候会盖更多的这种毯子啊，被子。
So then, to wake up in the morning, we have to remove the covering. We have to take off the covering.
但是在早上起床的时候，我们就把所有的被子给掀开。
But sometimes we don't like to get up. We pull the blankets over. No, no, let me stay.
但是有时候我们就不愿意把被子掀开，我们想在这个被子里面再多待一会儿。
So the soul was like that. Our soul, we become covered by the material energy, and we don't want to leave the material energy.
所以这个灵魂就是这样的，灵魂被这种物质能量覆盖着，但是灵魂又不愿意离开这种物质的能量。
Instead of controlling the mind, we take direction from the mind.
只需要控制我们的心意，然后给予我们的心意一种正确的引导。
No, because we don't control the mind. The mind controls us.
因为我们并没有控制心意，所以心意在控制我们。
And intelligence is not used properly.
那个时候，智性没有被恰当的运用。
So we have to purify the mind and intelligence. We have to use them properly in the service of Krishna.
因此我们应该净化我们的心意和智性，恰当地运用它们，让它们去服务 Krishna.
Recognize our spiritual position as a servant of Krishna.
我们永恒的这种地位是服务 Krishna.
Okay.
Okay. 好了，
古
代，我们最后一个问题回答完了。
好，谢谢。Okay.
谢谢。
今天到这儿 ，Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada.
Jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki jai.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.